Symptoms would be lethargy or disinterest. We're not seeing other people because we don't care about other people. We're too tired to do that. We don't think we have anything to contribute to that, so we're not doing it.
We lose family members. We often lose a spouse. We often see our friends dying. And so that changes our social network significantly.
It's really important that we tune into each other and recognize when somebody is hurting emotionally. The five signs of emotional suffering: change in personality. We can see that. When someone starts to change and you say to yourself, you know, mom or dad, they're not who they used to be, that should be an indication to tune into that. Withdrawal from someone's normal social activities tells us something. Agitation. If somebody's angry all the time and they didn't used to be, or they're agitated all the time, that tells us something. Lack of personal care. When someone stops taking care of themselves the way they used to, they don't go out for walks anymore, they don't dress up anymore, they're eating too much, they're not eating enough, tells us something. And finally, hopelessness. People will communicate when they feel hopeless, when they feel there's no point going on. They will say the words, they will tell us in their actions. Those things we need to pay attention to, and we need to reach out and connect and make sure that they know we care about them, and we want to help them figure out what's happening so that they can feel better.
When you give up that driver's license, the independence seems to go crashing down, especially people in their 80s, as they have to turn it over because they realize that they can't drive any longer. That's a big issue.
I was knocking on doors, talking to a woman. Her husband had died 5 years before. He did all the driving, he did all the grocery shopping, he took care of all the bills. And the woman was virtually in tears because she said that, you know, getting a cab was hard for her. And she literally poured her heart out to me that for 70 years, she didn't have to do any of these things. And her husband died 5 years earlier, her children live out of town, and now she's stuck in her home.
They would rather accept help from a stranger than have to go to their children and say, I need your help, because of the cultural context of looking weak and dependent to the children that you raised.
We need to tell them in many different ways how much we value them so that they are continuing to be productive members well to the end of their lives.